Times in England Revolution announced on Sunday that the club hired Kurt Onelfo as technical director, with Richie Williams brought on as assistant coach. Onelfo, a 49-year-old São Paulo, Brazil native, has been a coach in the United States since 2000 when he joined DC United as an assistant. Since, he has spent time with Sporting Kansas City, the LA Galaxy in the US youth national team, leading both MLS clubs for a time and taking charge of the US U20 and U23 sides. He will report directly to Bruce Arena, who was named Sporting Director and Head Coach on May 14. Arena is familiar with Onelfo from his first stint with the USMNT and more recently with the Galaxy, where Onelfo served as an assistant until Arena left to take the USMNT job in late 2016 and Onelfo was named his successor. Most recently Onelfo was out in Poland with Tep Ramos and the U20 side at the World Cup. I am very pleased to add Kurt to our technical staff as we continue to build this soccer organization in New England, Arena said in the official club release. Having worked with Kurt for many years, I know his vast knowledge and experience in the game will make him an immediate asset to the club. Williams, meanwhile, left his job as head coach of USL club Loudoun United FC to take the position with the Revolution. He has previously been with Arena as an assistant with the USMNT during Arena's second stint in with the New York Red Bulls before that. During his playing days, Williams made 20 appearances for the USMNT and played for Arena with DC United in the national team, and even as far back as in college at Virginia, where Arena spent 27 years as head coach. Richie and I have a relationship that dates back nearly 30 years, and I have the utmost confidence that he will bring the same energy, enthusiasm, and expertise of the game to the Revolution that he has throughout each stop of his coaching and playing career. Arena said in the release. Follow at the _bonfire. The kids are getting another chance to leave an impression on Greg Berhalter, with one player making his full debut in Wednesday 7 Uhr abends. ET kickoff against Jamaica. Follow USMNTV. Jamaica, San Joseph Jackson UEL will be in the midfield for his first cap, working with VEL Trapp, Christian Roldan, Paul Ariola, and Georgia Mihailovic. Josh Sargent is up top, while the back line consists of Tim Riem, Omar Gonzalez, Matt Miazga, and Anthony Robinson in front of Zach Steffen. The USMNT will play Venezuela on Sunday before opening its Gold Cup campaign with Guyana on Tuesday.
United States Rolled Up Newspaper Team News is in. Here's your
Soccer MNT at USM, June 5, 2019. Follow at Nicolas Mandola. We've got a fee for Eden Hazard, according to The Guardian's Fabrizio Romano. Real Madrid will reportedly buy the Chelsea superstar for approximately $113 million plus bonuses. Hazard will join a Real Madrid renovation which already includes Eder Militao and Luka Jovic. If the fee is accurate, those three players alone will have cost Real $243 million. More Premier League VAR details. The club is not expecting to slow down anytime soon, now linked with Paul Pogba amongst others. But Real will have to sell players as well, with Gareth Bale amongst the headliners expected to depart the Bernabeu. Hazard, 28, joined Chelsea from Lille in 2012 and posted 110 goals and 92 assists in 352 appearances for the Blues. The Belgian international won 2 Premier League titles, an FA Cup, a League Cup und 2 Europa League crowns. Equal, he'll have a chance to win a top flight title in his third country, having won Liga 1 with Lille von 2010 bis 11. Flo at Nicolas Mandola it's kinda what he does, you know, scoring huge goals. Cristiano Ronaldo scored a hat-trick as Portugal clinched the spot in the inaugural UEFA Nations League final with a 3-1 defeat of Switzerland on Wednesday at the Estadio do Dragão. More Premier League VAR details. Ronaldo's match winner came in the 88th minute of a feeder from Bernardo Silva, and then the Portuguese megastar cooked Manuel Akanji en route to a 90th minute insurance goal. Ricardo Rodriguez scored a penalty kick for Switzerland's lone goal. Ronaldo's performance came on the same day that the American lawsuit filed against Ronaldo for rape was moved to federal court. The first goal was wonderful, a free kick sent through the wall after Ronaldo was fouled to win the opportunity, though it came after Bruno Fernandes was somehow not sent off for a sliding stats up change. To be fair to Portugal, Swiss midfielder Granit Xhaka could also have been sent off minutes later for a two-footed change. The goals were the 86th, 87th, and 88th of his Portugal senior career. Really, the performance saved the storyline, which would have been all about VAR after a penalty awarded to Portugal was never given thanks to a video review which nullified the foul in order to give a dodgy penalty to the Swiss. That in itself had a measure of fairness as the Swiss were the better team on the day. They just didn't have Cristiano Ronaldo. Ronaldo makes it 3, he gets his 7th career hat-trick with Portugal, pic.twitter.com/98E4395SDD, ESPNFC at ESPN June 5, 2019. Follow at Nicolas Mandola. The Premier League has released more details regarding next season's introduction of video assistant referee to the competition. When a call is overturned via definitive proof, stadia with big screens will show the footage in question to fans. More Ronaldo scores free kick for stadia like Anfield in Old Trafford that do not have screens. Announcements will be made over the public address system. The Premier League also announced that it is considering the possibility of messages and video clips being viewed on handheld devices via an app. For more information, here's the full release from PremierLeague.com. Follow at Nicolas Mandola, let's block it. Why?